VicRoads contracted Leighton Contractors to design and construct Melbourne's 9.3-kilometre Deer Park bypass in December 2006. The four-lane dual carriageway will run from the Western Highway at Caroline Springs to the Western Ring Road in Sunshine West. The Western Highway is the main road link between Melbourne and Adelaide in Australia and carries over 70,000 vehicles per day through Deer Park. David Teague, Project Strategic Support Manager VicRoads, talks about the project.
The section of road that we're bypassing has a history of fatal crashes and a crash history, and that includes on average one fatality per year. It's also quite heavily used by freight traffic. So by building this bypass and getting it open a year earlier, those benefits from the reduced greenhouse emissions, travel time savings, as well as the safety savings by not having the crash statistics, only adds to the benefit to the people of Victoria.
The new road will significantly reduce traffic congestion around Melbourne's expanding outer western suburbs, bypassing 20 intersections and 6 sets of traffic lights. Once completed, the bypass is anticipated to reduce travel times by up to 15 minutes during peak periods. Although the project is being delivered under a design and construct contract for VicRoads, certain alliance contract characteristics have been adopted under what is being called a one-team environment. Working from the same office, alongside the Leighton Contractors staff, VicRoads is a part of the construction process. Previously, if VicRoads required clarification on an issue, Leighton Contractors would have to issue a written communication to VicRoads, who would review it, and then have to return an official written response. If the response was not positive, then the procedure would be repeated until an agreement was made. However, on this project, meetings between appropriate VicRoads and Leighton Contracts parties can resolve the issue immediately. Documentation confirming the agreed outcome is uploaded into the system to complete the process and accommodate probity concerns. Currently, structure works are about 60% complete. Deer Park Bypass features 14 bridge structures. 123 precast concrete beams have been manufactured for use in these bridges in a joint venture between Leighton Contractors and a local Melbourne manufacturer. A specially fabricated large steel box girder spanning the inbound and outbound lanes of the Western Ring Road intersection is being manufactured in Newcastle. 6 kilometres of 6-metre-high noise walls and 27 sign gantries are also currently under construction. The bypass requires 2.46 million cubic metres of earthworks, 246,000 cubic metres of pavement and 192,000 tonnes of asphalt. The earthworks' critical path follows the complex intersection at the Western Ring Road. One significant area requiring excavation near the Western Ring Road alone contained over 200,000 cubic metres of dirt. Another earthworks innovation has been the use of belly dumpers rather than trucks and trailers, making the placement of pavement safer and more efficient. Dean Anderson, Roadworks Manager, Leighton Contractors, talks about the project.
The other interesting thing that we've done, I guess, with Roadworks is with regards to the pavement. For the past 30 years, VicRoads have had a standard pavement design, which is basically the black asphalt. We've used some local products. Right next to our job, we're just over here, we're lucky to have a Boral quarry. That Boral quarry being so close to the alignment means we have access to a number of different products. And using those products and importing some brick dust, we've managed to redesign our asphalt pavement layers and our CTM pavements. And that means that we're making a few savings on laying our asphalt out on the project.
Traffic management is the most significant safety issue on the project, particularly on the Western Ring Road, which carries about 3,000 cars per hour. Concrete barriers have been installed to protect workers, and a safety culture has been fostered through regular face-to-face and group safety meetings. The entire workforce is encouraged to come up with safety suggestions through the project's Shout Awards, run totally by the employees, and resulting in a number of excellent safety initiatives. Dust and noise are major issues for the Deer Park Bypass team. Despite Australia's water shortage, water must be sprayed to keep dust levels down. As a result of this, the project team sunk 4 bores along the length of the project to supply that water. local councils will be able to use the bores for ongoing environmental maintenance and irrigation after the project's completion. Furthermore, some parts of the project run very close to residential and commercial properties, so noise and vibration levels are constantly monitored, and a community relations team regularly interacts with neighbours to ensure that any issues are quickly dealt with.
One of the major environmental concerns on the project was the impact it could potentially have on a number of endangered species. The striped legless lizard, the pale swamp everlasting, golden sun moth and the spiny rice flower are all examples of flora and fauna that are on the endangered list. Before the project commenced, we did a full survey of the site, and where we identified any of these species actually have translocated them to surrounding areas, where with Parks Victoria and local councils we've set up protected habitats to not only protect them from any damage we might cause, but also put them in an area where they may thrive and increase in their numbers.
As a result of all parties working together as one team, the project has become extremely streamlined. Shared goals for time, cost and safety are motivating everyone so highly that the project is set to open 6 months early.